Welcome back to Speller Tutorial Services. In today's video, we're going to construct the end center of this particular circle. Once we create the end center, we're going to then draw a circle that's going to be inscribed inside of this triangle. So we begin this by drawing angle bisectors for each one of these angles. So angle X, Y, and Z will have an angle bisector. And from previous videos, we know that an angle bisector is a line that will cut an angle in half. So let's begin by setting our compass to an arbitrary radius and then placing the pointy end on one of the vertices. Here we're starting with vertices or vertex X. All right, when we do that, we're going to create an arc that's going to intersect this triangle at two positions. Let's place the pointy end at the top position here, and then we're going to create another arc. And then we'll create another arc. And then let's place the pointy end down at this lower intersection of the arc and the side, and we're going to draw another arc, paying attention to where those last two arcs intersect. And once we do that, we're going to put the ruler in place, because now we want to draw a line which is going to be the actual angle bisector. It's going to extend from angle X to and through where these two arcs intersect. And let's draw that here. Now let's go ahead and get rid of some of these excess markings. So these arcs here can go. And now I'm going to move on to vertex Y. Again, placing the pointy end on Y. And then I want to draw another arc. And again, we see this arc intersecting at two places. Without changing the radius, let me go ahead and place the pointy end on one of those locations that intersect the side and draw another arc. And then do the same thing from this intersection here on the right-hand side. And again, I'm looking to see where they intersect. And I have my intersection here. And again, back to my straight edge. And the straight edge is going to go from the vertex to where these two arcs actually intersect. And that would be about there. And I'm going to extend this bisector. Again, I'm going to get rid of the excess so it's easier to see what we're doing in this particular drawing or this particular construct. And last but not least, let's move down and begin our work on angle Z. Alright, again, the pointy end on Z. Let's draw our first arc. There it is, crossing two sides of the triangle, not changing the radius of the compass. Let's place it at one of those intersections, draw another arc, and then let's go to the top intersection here, and then let's place that, and then let's draw another arc. Alright, get this protractor tool out of the way. And now back with the straight edge. Place this position here at the vertex to get that lined up. And then I want to line it up with where we have that intersection at. And that intersection is about there. Alright, now let's draw our last angle bisector. And one last time, or just one more time, let's go ahead and clean up the extras that we have here on the drawing. So that arc goes, this arc goes, and this arc goes. This location here where all these lines intersect, it's the point of concurrency. And in this particular example, since we're using bisectors, this is called the end center. All right, with the end center, we're now able to create a circle that's going to be inscribed inside of this triangle. So we do that by placing the pointy end of the protractor on our end center, and then we're going to set the radius of the compass to be the same as the distance from the end center to where to where one of these angle bisectors touches the side here. Again, we see it's a little, I'm a little off. I can't get exactly where I want it to be, so I'm going to draw my circle from here. And really, the circle should, arcs or pieces of the circle should actually touch in this location here, and this location here. I'm off, so it's not going to actually touch. It's going to come extremely, extremely close. But here you get the idea that when you use angle bisectors for every angle of a triangle to find the end center, once you found that end center, you can create a circle that will be inscribed inside the triangle. All right, that sums it up for this video from Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the same name. And again, thank you for watching.